I'm glad that you're here with us for another devotion. And I'm out in the yard, right behind the parsonage where I live. And as you can see behind me, there's this row of blue spruce trees. They're on really on kind of the border of our property. And what's fascinating about this row of trees is if you look at it, you're going to notice that you have these very tall blue spruce and then a very short one, almost about two-thirds of the height of the trees next to it. And then, of course, it's right next to this big tree that kind of overshadows it. Now, there's really a point to this, which is this idea that the short tree, it doesn't get nearly as much sun. Why? Because earlier in the day, it's blocked by the taller blue spruce trees next to it to the east. And then on the west side, right by it, it has this big shade tree that, of course, stops some of the light from getting it. In fact, it's really crowding it at the top. And then it takes moisture. All the rain that falls there, the blue spruces get their share of it, and then the big shade tree, it gets some share of the moisture. So it's not in an ideal condition. Now, what I'd like to know, if we had a bit of a time to do an experiment, it would be fascinating to cut the shade tree down, also cut down the hickory tree next to it, or the mulberry tree, I should say, next to it, and let more sun hit this tree. Open it up. I'll bet it would start to catch these other trees. But if the circumstances around the tree don't change, well, it'll be stunted in its growth. It has the potential to grow. There's no doubt about it. It's just not in the right conditions. So it's always going to be shorter. It's still trying, but it can't get past the shade. I wonder, when we think about that in our own life, what are the things that are the shade in our life? What are the things, whether it's self-inflicted or other people are kind of putting shade into our life with discouragement, words that aren't encouraging? All those things kind of add up, whether we're doing it to ourselves or we're in an environment that's difficult, and it can be challenging to grow. The first thing that has to take place here is we've got to do some cutting down of those things. I don't know about your life, but in my life, I can think of some things that I believe if I was to do from, you know, to get rid of, you might say, would help me to grow. But it's not just that. I mean, if we took that big shade tree down, that would really help that blue spruce to grow. But we could also do some other things. We could put some fertilizer in the ground. We could give it additional water. We could do some proactive things to be able to help that tree grow. Well, the same thing would be true in our own life. I could spend some more time in God's Word, where the faith and strength really builds from that. I could do a number of positive things. I could get involved in a ministry. I could spend more time in prayer. I could meditate on a scripture. There are those positive things that will help us grow. But also we have to look at the things that might be limiting our growth, like what we have right here. Just for a few moments today, maybe reflect on something that might be limiting your growth in the Lord. What might that be? And how could you work around that situation? Well, let's pray about that together right now. Lord, we thank you for your love and your grace to us. Just like this blue spruce tree, I think we all feel like that from time to time. There are different things that are kind of blocking us in, and it doesn't seem like we're able to really grow and reach our potential. Things that maybe that we're involved with that we shouldn't be, and we know we shouldn't be, but we kind of got caught up in it, or we found ourselves almost addicted to different things. So help us, Lord, to take an assessment of our life. What might be blocking the sun light of Jesus in our life, the light of the world? What might be blocking that and kind of shading us? And at the same time, Lord, what could we add to our life, like fertilizer and water and all that kind of, what could we do? Maybe reflecting on the scriptures, having devotions, adding prayer. What could we do to grow positively? Lord, help us to discern those things, because we don't want to be like this blue spruce that's blocked in and is not able to reach its potential. We want to reach our potential in you. So help us to do that for your glory. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Well, God bless you. We'll see you Sunday morning. You can watch us traditional online, 8 a.m., or contemporary at 10 a.m., or you can join us outside right here, just next to where I'm at 9:30. God bless you. Whatever one of those works for you, we hope we'll see you on Sunday. Bye-bye.